subscribe to our channel now and press the bell icon to never miss an update from KIMS Global.
Hi, I am Dr. Sandeep.B.P, surgical oncologist, KIMS Cancer Center, Trivandrum. Cancer, as I said, is a genetic disease, but there is a fine line between calling something genetic and calling something hereditary. There are two different terms. Heredity means a disease is transferred from the older generation to the younger generation. Genetic just means that the disease has got its effect on the genes of an individual. So the disease in the genes can be either passed over generations, that is called a hereditary genetic defect, or it can even be a sporadic or a disease which is captured during the lifetime of an individual. So this is like a person who has a disease can pass over part of the disease to his next generations. The other one, a person lives and acquires certain changes in his genes which will lead to cancer. The best example being cigarette smoking. When you smoke cigarettes, it is not the genes that you got from your parents that is creating trouble. It is the genes that you have with constant genetic damage produced by cigarettes or alcohol or any form of tobacco or some viruses or even environmental pollution. All these factors act on your genetic material to create trouble. Naturally, most of us are exposed to these genetic changes, but luckily, we have all got a defense mechanism. Our genes are constantly changing and most of the defects are constantly being scrutinized and repaired. So whenever there is a defect in this repair mechanism, it is then that you have a higher chance of developing cancer. When it comes to familial tendency to cancer, the most often cited example is that of breast cancer. About 10% of breast cancers can be considered to be acquired due to changes in the genetics acquired from the parents. 90% of breast cancers are sporadic. That means they have nothing to do with your familial predisposition. But at the same time, we should be aware that if our family has got more than 2 members with breast cancer, the chance of having a breast cancer is slightly higher than that of general population. That is where we should alert such individuals with a high family history to be proactive, to detect any lumps and respond in time, to reach a doctor in time, to get tested and start treatment at the earliest. So that is the importance of identifying the genetic factors. Another important area where genetics has got a definite role is a case of colorectal cancer, where a family of persons may be at a higher risk of developing multiple small polyps in the colon, which can over a period of time turn into cancer. Such people also should be considered for constant surveillance. That is, in between they have to undergo checking like a colonoscopy or blood testing or stool testing and things like that, or sometimes even genetic testing. This is a very vast area, so we can discuss it in some other context. But as far as genetic predisposition is concerned, we should understand that very few cancers have got very strong genetic predisposition. The classic example being that of the famous film actress Angelina Jolie, who had a very strong family history of breast cancer, so much so that she had to undergo a genetic testing which found her to be at a higher risk of developing breast cancer, and naturally she had to undergo some remedial surgical procedures to prevent cancer. So such things are possible.